Well, I'm jumping straight into a fishing trip rather than a synopsis at home. Just didn't get time yesterday, but it's Saturday, 12th of September 2020. And yeah, sombre day yesterday, as it always is, September 11th, watching the telly. And yeah, 19 years ago, and crikey, we all know where we were at that time. But anyway, on a lighter note, I'm at Renard, Carl's Lake, which is about 5 hours from Calais. For the first time, Cole's had this a few years and we'll catch up with him. He used to have Pascal's, which he sold on the Joncourt complex, and put his money into this. I've never been to a fishery like it. It's more manicured than my garden. It's more manicured than my living room. But yeah, that apart, it really is a beautiful place. We've got high pressure, hot weather for all week, which we could have done without, but it is what it is. And right now I'm getting set up, going for an early dinner, and then I'll get back and get the rods out. But for now, yeah, beautiful place, and yeah, in a lovely part of France. To rewind slightly, as I speak, I've not edited my three earlier French trips. The first one was to Beauce, the second one was to Rainbow, well, no, two French trips, and the third trip was Sumba at Croatia. But by the time you're watching this, I'm sure to have edited those three videos. Caught some lovely fish, had, you know, met some great people, had a great time. And this now is my fourth trip abroad, which means I've also got a quarantine with all the measures in place right now with COVID. But anyway, right now, going to get my gear sorted, catch up with Dinny and Carl, have a bite to eat, get back and get them out. Yeah, I've never fish swimmed like this. Look at this. And here's my swim for the week. I can move, there's plenty of scope to move. There's just Dinny and I fishing. But I'm at the gate end, so to speak. Dinny's at the other end. And I've got a lot of water to go at, not least of all behind this island here, where you can fish during the day, because the fish do get around there. So, yeah, plenty of scope. I've got three rods now. One's going over in the corner, one out in straight in front of me, and one sort of on the edge of that island. But anyway, as I say, right now, just need to get the gear all sorted and go and get a bite to eat. Well, just been round, had a burger with the boys, and back now, got the rods out, and I'm guessing it's about 7:30, and yeah, seen a couple of fish in front of me, so yeah, all to play for, feeling confident. You never landed a fish for me before, I do worry. Dinny's told me about ya. You're on it, well done, Cole. Oh, happy days. Yeah.
From the line.
That's it. You on it?
Yeah.
There we go. About 35 pound. 34 pound. Something like that.
It's gone.
Yeah,
lovely.
Yeah, that fish was 34 and a half. So, yeah, great start. Got it back out there again. Nice time to get a bite. And I was saying to Carl, there's a spot to the left of where I had that fish that I've seen a few fish move on now, and it might be better approached from the left swim. So there's every chance I might move up to that. But this swim's been extended, so you do get a better angle at it. I'm just going to play it by ear overnight. But yeah, there's a few fish moving out there, that's for sure. Well, first light, Sunday morning. Got this common, probably about 23 pound. Well, just had a lovely dinner with the boys Sunday evening. No sooner as I got back to my swim to get them out for the evening, sun's going down, Dinny's had one. So yeah, good and by the sound of things. So I'm walking back round there now to get it on the camera. He had an occurrence earlier while we was having dinner. And yeah, there's been some fish moving out there. So yeah, happy days. Yeah, look at this place. Unbelievable what Carl's done here. Yeah, so Dinny's fishing the double swim. There's Carl's lodge, there's the angler's lodge, barbecue area. Nice one, Din, well done. Was it that rod?
Yeah.
So what, was it hanging on there?
Yeah, picked the rod up, started winding down, it started kiting right.
There you go, so it was sitting there trying to get rid of the hook.
That's what he just said,
didn't yeah.
Big fish,
wasn't
it?
Wow, big fish. Yeah. Yeah? Yeah, well done. Yeah, so that was the rod that had the occurrence. Yeah, it just shows you. That's gone off somewhere, sat there trying to get rid of it.
Yeah.
Five and a bit, 45 and three quarters.
Yeah,
nice one, Din. Yeah, well done. Happy days.
Yep.
Yeah, nice one, Din.
Oh, he's gone.
He's gone. Well, we got it.
You weren't holding him. I just felt him flexing every time I bloody.
Well done, Din. Nice fish. Just shows you that swam off, sat somewhere.
Sat there.
Yeah. Yeah, nice one. Well, well I'll get back.
Saying,
I want one then.
Yeah.
Well done, mate.
It took 12.
Yeah, as we were saying there, when we was having dinner, we were thinking that was a possum chat. That's obviously swum off a bit, sat there. Dinny's wound it in, or gone to wind it in. Boom, off it's gone. So yeah, wise old fish. But yeah, lovely, lovely common. I want one of them. Well, it's 8:30 Monday morning, and that weren't the night I had planned, because I didn't catch anything. And right now, there's fizzing all over my baited area, which I'm going to try and get on the camera. And yeah, I'm astonished I didn't have a bite over there. Something's not right, I don't know what's going on. I don't know whether the poisson chat are wiping me out as well. Mind you, with all that fizzing, as I say, it certainly looks carpy, but yeah, let's have a look. Yeah, we'll have a closer look at the bivvy. I put a couple of short videos on my Facebook page when I got this. So, yeah, first time it's been up. I'm actually sleeping under the stars. It's so warm at night and obviously during the day. Anyway, let's have a cup of tea. But yeah, great bit of kit. Well, Carl's just left the swim. Chatting with him, saying I'm amazed I didn't have a bite with a fizzing. And then my right hand rod's gone. I think I've got it off the island. This feels like a good fish. Yeah, about 8:30. Carl! Yeah, when I wound in yesterday, Carl, there was a twig round one of the rods. A mirror. Hold on. Have your wits about you, Carl, because Dinny's told me all about you.
Yeah? Sorry, mate.
Go on, stick that out. Did it? Oh, nice fish, Carl. Look at that. That's a beauty. Look at that.
Yep.
Okay. You can get one more time this side. It's a prettier side. Yeah, on it.
Yep.
Lovely. Mm. Thank you, fish.
Nice.
Got a chuff with that. Yeah, beauty. Mm. Absolute beauty. Look at that.
Well, chuff with that.
Wow, how good was that? 43 and a half that fish. What a fight. Got that on the glasses as well. Well chuffed with that. Not long after I got the video out, I'm looking at that bubbling, and when Cole's round, we're chatting. I said to him, look at that bubbling out there. I'm amazed I ain't had a bite. And then you start to think, you know, if I wind in and it's tangled and everything else, and yeah, no sooner had Cole gone, boom, it ripped off. So yeah, well chuffed with that. My third fish, and yeah, I needed it. Happy days and beautiful mirror. And these fish, like Cole was saying, they need to be feeding up. Because they're, you know, they, that fish could easily be 50 pound. And what am I going to say? I'm going to say, yeah, I think over the coming weeks, probably October, November, this lake will kick off when these temperatures cool down. The water's going up again in terms of the heat that we're having this week. But it's like all these lakes, there's a witching time. If you're lucky, you've got a booking when all of a sudden the weather's right and the fish have got to feed and know they've got to feed, you can have it off. And the way this weather's been here now, you know, that's probably going to happen, you know, second half of October, I reckon. But anyway, yeah, right now, cup of tea, and yeah, well chuffed. Enough of the rambling bullshit. Yeah, cup of tea's needed. Tunes on the radio and a cup of tea. And a beautiful day. And I'm proper happy. Well, it's about 1 o'clock now, Monday. I had that fish this morning. And then I've gone up, had some breakfast with the boys, and I'm back now with one rod out until tea time when I'll go up for dinner. So not exactly hardcore fishing. And, you know, if it was a low pressure and, you know, bang on conditions, I'd probably be fishing all day and Dinny would kindly bring my dinner up. Maybe that's not the case. But anyway, yeah, it's relaxed. And but yeah, pleased to have had that one. And yeah, not fishing hard right now, but enjoying myself. That's the main thing. And yeah, again, real hot. Got a breeze coming up my way now, which is handy. So as I say, one rod out where fish were bubbling earlier. And yeah, for a few hours. Well, it's been out about half hour. Monday lunchtime. Put one rod out on those bubbling areas, having gone for breakfast, brunch, and it's gone off. And again, feels another good fish, slow fish, and really exciting pulling into these, because they proper do tear off. And in the heat of the day, you know, in hindsight, well, not even with hindsight, you know, I shouldn't have gone up and had breakfast. I was on fish, but anyway, I'm chilling out and it's my way of fishing. I enjoy it, but right now those fish are there, and that was obvious by the amount of bubbling that was going on this morning. Get you.
In she goes.
Get in. Needed that one, didn't we? Yeah.
Well angled, Kev. Worth coming back round,
yeah,
here, wasn't it?
Lovely. Yeah, it's said you, didn't I, about the bubbling, Dim?
Yeah.
Aren't
yeah.
me, I'm photogenic. Come closer.
All right. You are.
I'm happy with that.
You are, is it, haven't you? You are very photogenic, Kev,
yeah.
Unlike me.
Yeah.
Which is unusual, because I'm a good looking fucker in
come
real
in
life.
Come in close and have a look at it, Dim. Oh, get down there, didn't I? Get there, get that close.
God.
Get that close.
Yep.
Out.
Look at that.
It's just
great.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. He's a bigger mate.
Nice one.
Yeah.
Lovely, boys.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's got a bit of go. He's a little bit empty, looks.
Yeah.
Yeah? Yeah, well happy with that, Din. Bang on.
Be interested to see what he weighs, because he's one of the fat ones.
Yeah, you on it?
Yep.
Text good?
Yep.
Right.
Yep. Bigger than he?
50 plus, I think.
It's a nice weight.
It's a nice weight.
Nice, yeah. Getting it off. Yeah. Look at that. What a peach that is, Din. Come out. Oh, you took your cat, did you?
Yeah.
Look at that, Din. What a beauty, eh?
He's 50, isn't he?
Yeah, I think so.
You've got to be pleased with that.
Go on, you weigh him. I'll,
Oh, mate! Yeah? Oh.
52 and a half?
Yeah.
Yeah, 52 and a half?
Yeah.
Well done. Happy days.
Oh. That's a pretty one.
Got it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah?
Get the other side.
Yeah, mate.
Yeah, all good?
Yeah.
Yeah, mate. Super.
Thank you, fish. Beauty. What a beautiful fish.
Big, isn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, he's been feeding that one. He's not as hollow as the others.
No, no. Just what we were just saying, he's a fat one, isn't he?
Yeah. Oh, well happy with that, boys.
Well done.
Yeah, thanks.
On my rig and all.
On your rig. How
well
good
done.
Was that?
Perfect. Yep.
Cheers, boys. Well, I think it's about 4 o'clock. The second bite on the single rod that I've got out there. Don't feel as big as the last one. It's coming back. That's a nice one, Cole, isn't it?
Looks it. Quite big head on him, big shoulders.
Head, yeah.
Yep.
Oh, she's up.
Oh.
Yeah, Din, Din looks so long, and then all of a sudden, the width of it, I'm thinking that's a big fish.
Yeah. It's a pretty one, isn't it? Yeah. Clean, isn't it?
So we already zeroed that, haven't we? The scales.
Look how empty, look.
Yeah.
It's just flat.
Yeah.
It's empty.
Yeah, it'd be it's probably a scrape of 50, you reckon?
Yeah.
Either way, proper happy with that, Din.
Exactly. That's all that matters.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. Got the pecs all in. Hold, check the
pecs. Just a minute ago.
Yeah?
All good.
49. Yeah, happy days. Well chuffed.
Well done.
Right.
Same spot, Kev, off the
same
island.
Same spot, just one rod out there. I went far off winding in coming around for dinner.
What, we cooking your dinner again?
Well, you might be bringing it up to me, Din.
What's going on? Just, yeah, I know, we'd do that. Get your rods out, mate. We'd bring it up.
Yeah, no, I was just going to say, if you want to, we're sticking it because it's it is.
I'll give that a pause, Din, and then start again.
He's been here for 3.5 months on his own. Don't need to see that. Oh,
no!
Yeah.
No!
Yeah. Oh, well happy with that.
Yeah, I should think you are.
Yeah.
Yeah, well done.
Superb.
Get it back out of there, mate. We'll do your dinner and bring it round.
Yeah. All right. Do you know what I'll do now, that Roger? I'll come round for a quick shower and then
you want to do.
Bring my dinner round. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, happy days.
Yeah, superb.
Get one out there.
Well, it's 6:30 now, Monday evening, and the boys are kindly bringing my dinner round because I went back for a shower, caught up with them. And yeah, having had 2 fish today after a quiet night last night, you know, it was a relief more than anything else. And 2 beautiful fish, well chuffed with them. And yeah, shame that common jumped out of my hands. But anyway, yeah, lovely fish. And I think there's a lot to be said, guys, to be fair to Colin and other waters, of handling fish when you can get in the margins, in the margin. I know Luke at Gravier's, I remember him doing it, started it many years ago. And yeah, it works. And yeah, provided of course you can get in the margin. So for me, fish up to say 30 pound, I'll just do them on the mat in the absence of bringing coal round every time. But over that size, yeah, putting them in the water, it's a good call. Obviously in the winter you're using chest waders, but now that's like a bath, that must be 24 degrees, something like that. But anyway, and obviously it needs to be safe, you know. So yeah, you know, don't get me wrong, you know, it ain't just as simple as getting in the margin. You've got to know it's safe, but you know, that's for fishery owners to work out. Anyway, right now, having a cup of tea, come back, as I say, after the shower. I'm just going to fish 2 rods tonight, and I'm changing the angle slightly. And yeah, I'm proper on it. And I always say on these videos, I'm at my best when I'm catching fish. I'm a better angler when I'm catching, I'm a crap angler when I'm not. And I don't know how that sort of computes, but that's how I see it. Anyway, I'm proper on it. Whereas when I'm not catching, I feel I don't work as hard. Whereas I know other people that work hard whether they're catching or not. And they're the special anglers out there. For me, yeah, I'll just do it my way, to coin a phrase from Des O'Connor. Well, it's 7:00. I was putting just 2 rods out, but there's a fish moved down there to my right, about 70 yards, 60 yards towards the house. So I've put a rod down there and it's in that line, probably 60 yards out, well off the island, sort of in line with the end of the house. Look what the boys have brought round for me. Shepherd's pie. Top boys, thanks guys. Well, I just did that cutaway shot of me eating dinner and the fish are out there where I've baited. Yeah, it looks mad for it. Really does. Them 2 rods there and then one there on the clutch. Those 2 are locked up. That's on the clutch. So, yeah, this is the scene Monday evening and, yeah, really enjoying myself. High pressure, hot, still. But catching some fish.
Go on.
So was this 35 and a half?
35 and a half.
Yeah. Monday evening, early evening.
Yep. There we go. Lovely.
Super. Let's turn this round. This is going to go. Made me a right merry dance. This 44 and a half common. It's about 11:30 Monday night. I can never doubt this. I think it's going to jump.
You watch.
There we are, 44 and a half. There it goes. 44 and a half pound. What a fight that was and all. So yeah, well chuffed with that. I think that's my 7th fish. I think 7th or 8th, I'm not sure. But yeah, well happy with that. Got to regroup now. First thing I'm gonna do is have a cup of tea. I phoned Cole. No answer. He'd had a few beers. I weren't expecting an answer somehow. There we go, 32 pound Tuesday morning, first light. Happy days. Yeah, no sooner had I done that sunrise shot Tuesday morning, this went off. Look at this fish. Look at that, beautiful. Go on then, lift it up, Cole.
Hold on, I'm going to be spraying quickly.
First thing I check these days, my cod's hanging out of that. I get so much sick about that. There we go, 45 and a half.
Yeah.
Get the other side, Cole.
Yeah.
So that if it swims off,
going, oh no, going straight into the woodwork.
Yeah, so we get a bit of an angle. Yeah, you on it?
Yeah.
45 and a half. All right, Cole.
Well, you've got to be happy with that. What a beautiful mirror. 45 and a half. Short, fat thing. Bit close to home, that. Well, happy. I have another cup of tea now. It's about 9 o'clock. And I just knew I was going to get a bite. I tried to phone Dinny earlier. Just say, Din, they're fizzing right over my spot. And sure enough, it's gone off. And thankfully, this fish has kited left. Half, mid-morning Tuesday. There we go. You on it?
Yeah, mate. Yeah.
Ooh. Lovely. We'll chuff with that.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Nice one.
Thanks, boys.
Yeah?
Yeah. Well, it's 1 o'clock now, Tuesday. Just popped round, had a brunch with the boys. Dinny's moved round to behind the island and see if he can nick one or two there this afternoon. And I've got one rod out as I did yesterday, given that I'll be fishing through till about five and then going up for a shower and then an early dinner. So yeah, it's been a great morning's fishing. The night weren't so hectic, but certainly the morning was. And what I didn't get on camera was a 30 pound common, real long fish, got it on the phone, so I must remember to put that phone footage onto the video. Yeah, lovely pristine common, really fought well, typical, you know, long lean male looking fish. But anyway, yeah, right now rod's back out, drinking plenty, it's red hot, and I'll probably get some drone footage either this afternoon or tomorrow. In the meantime, yeah, just chilling. It's a great place to chill, this, and certainly the weather to chill, although it's not ideal fishing conditions. I think I'd rather have this and it pissing down with rain, to be truthful. So, Tuesday evening now, fourth night approaching. It's been a great session so far. It's been red hot today. And, yeah, I do wonder with that temperature going up, whether it's starting to get too warm. But, anyway, got to be positive and... yeah, we wound in today and just chilled out, did some drone footage. Yeah, it was too hot to be fishing. So, anyway, they're out. Boys are bringing kindly the dinner round for me so I can get plotted up, which I've done, and get the rods out. And, yeah, I think it is that, like it was last week apparently, it's that morning bite. I had that fish, or a couple in the night, didn't I? Then in the morning, the activity with the bubbling and everything else. So, yeah, we'll see. But, yeah. Right now, I need to put more sun cream on because it's like over 30 degrees. It's, you know, I think it's as hot as that back home, apparently. But anyway, yeah. Well, I was just eating dinner. Carl kindly brought it round. And I said to him, just before he got here, a big fish moved over on the spot. Don't think this is it. But as I'm into my second Kiev, it tore off. Oh, let me get me.
Well done, Cole. It looks like one of your old mirrors.
It does indeed.
Yeah.
Well, dinner time, Tuesday, 38 and a half, we said, didn't we?
Yep.
Look at that. Get the other side.
Yep.
An original fish, this, Cole, you say, yeah?
Yeah, definitely.
Look at this, you know, looking at it's old. A battle-scarred fish, isn't it?
It's old. Yeah, that's one of the old originals. Come out of Sone, probably 20, 25 years ago,
really?
I reckon. All of that.
Lovely, scaly fish, isn't it?
Yeah.
You can see
got
some
a few nice
creature.
Plates on one side, but she's getting a bit mottled now, where she's old, that's all.
There we go. Yep. Thank you, fish. Lovely. Oh, well pleased with that. Yeah.
Good.
39 and a half, Tuesday evening. Get the other side. So it's the second fish of this evening, Cole, isn't it?
Yeah.
Isn't it lively? There we go. There we are, 39 and a half.
Nice.
Oh, thank you, fish. So you can get it going back, Cole, over the top of it. You see that?
Yeah.
I've
got that, yeah. Go. Yeah, gone.
Lovely.
Nice one.
Oh, yeah, it's a great evening's fishing again.
Yeah, so this is the scene Wednesday morning. Quiet night. Can't see any bubbling or movement out there like yesterday, but this is bite time now. This is when I like to have a boat. Yeah, can you lift up that line? Yeah? As I was saying, it's caught up the other line. The tubing's right up the line. Just the sort of challenge we need on a Wednesday morning, Cole,
isn't it?
Yeah.
Wrapped down a few
times. What? I'm limited at the angle I can get to with that tree, Cole. So I think we better you come here. No.
Yeah.
Go on. Oh, happy days. Right.
Hell one now, I think.
Right, let's cut this line first and I'll let's come around to you.
We're just treating the mouth with the iodine like we do, but look at that mouth. How rubbery that is. Big mouth, isn't it?
That's a big lift. Yeah, still got full curtain, not been torn or nothing.
Well, this fish led us a merry dance. I was having a cup of tea with Cole, saying it was bite time. And it went off, took up the other line. But we got it in, 36 and a half common. And you're not going to see it very well with the sun behind me, but it's a different type of shot. Long fish, this ain't going to hang about. Had it?
Yep, nice.
Yeah, lovely. Well chuffed with that. So you can get your going back coal over the top of it. On it?
Yep.
Oh, that was fun, wasn't it? It's a quiet night. It's late evening, quiet nights, and then bite time in the morning. Yeah. Yeah, well pleased with that. Thanks for that, Cole.
No problem.
Well, it's just before 11 Wednesday morning. It's red hot, really hot. And I was going to wind in at 11, go and have some breakfast with the boys. But the last 20 minutes, bubbling's been occurring out where I've been catching the fish. So there were some fish there. So I need to give it till probably half 11, probably longer. But you know what? I'm hungry. Could do with a bit of a social. And, you know, good anglers would probably stay on their rods. But, yeah, I'm actually under this tree here. But, so I'm using that tree, because I'm close to my rods, I'm using that tree and the trunk to try and give me some shade from that sun, which at 7:30, 8 o'clock this morning, was just, relentless. But anyway, as I say, yeah, there's some movement going on out there. Well, it's approaching midday, Wednesday, as I said earlier, red hot. Wound in, fish are fizzing out in front of me. Going around for a barbecue, catch up with the boys, and I'll use this opportunity to have a look at a couple of the swims and other parts of the lake, not least of all catch up with Dinny and Carl. He's not that up for being on camera, I don't think, but we can at least ask him. Carl, who's the owner of the lake. Yeah, so my swim's about 100 yards behind me, the big sort of double swim. This is the swim opposite the island. There's a marker there of Dinny's that he's fishing to the back of from his swim in the absence of no one being in here. But yeah, there's the island there. And this is the avenue of trees. Look how beautiful that is. So I'm about halfway down the lake now. That's me up there, 100 odd yards. That was that island swim we just looked at. But yeah, well manicured. Really does look after it. And it's so quiet here. Apart from a bull that's got a bell round his neck that's having the time of his life. When he's having the time of his life, that bell rings. And it rings a lot. Reminds me of the 80s. Anyway, let's go and see the boys. Yeah, so having walked down that avenue, got to the bottom end of the lake now, just turning the corner. You can drive round to your swims here and unload, etc. But Carl then likes you to put the vehicles in the car park. So there's the lodge and Carl's place and the barbecue area. And then this is the first corner. Apparently this swim ain't been fished a great deal. You can look here, up the lake. That's me over there. There's the island. And I think Carl said it's about 12 or 13 acres. Sounds like Carl's baiting up for Dinny. I was going to go and suggest to Dinny he come and fish one rod each, me and him together up at my swim. For a bit of a social next few days. But by the sound of things, he's filling it in. All right, then. I stayed on my rods a little bit longer. They're fizzing the last couple of hours. Yeah, they're fizzing now. Yeah. There's some fish there. I was going to suggest to you about coming up and fishing a couple of nights with me, one rod each.
No, thanks.
No? That was a quick no.
You know when you said to me, where are they? I didn't get your message.
Right, yeah. Hold on, let me come down, Din. Because I messaged you last night, you'd gone to bed, I think, because I could hear the fish and I couldn't quite work out where they were.
The last couple of days, we've seen a few there, and when I pulled the lines in, that's where they seem to be getting there. That just comes up, it's mud all the way around, and you just put the stick on it, it comes up to about 5.5, 6 foot, but odd. And another one between the corner of your swim, you can see the marker, in line with that marker, but back this way. I've just wrapped it up. I've got to wrap it. So, yeah, we're going to give that a go. It's a bit slowed down here, isn't it? A lot of fish here the other day, but it seems as the minute you put them lines out, do you know what I mean? They go.
Right, yeah. If I was staying up there, I'd be pretty sure of a bite up there with fizzing.
Yeah. You're going to get
and,
them.
Yeah, but as I say, it's nice to in this heat.
He thought you'd keep clumping them and they'll come out of there, but no, you're holding them there.
Right. Yeah. So this is Dinny's swim, central sort of double swim facilities right behind you, looking up the lake. And I say, now that's me over there now. That's the end gate swim, they call it. And yeah, got some good drone footage yesterday.
You got all the fish, we got all the cold beer.
What are you doing now, Din?
Just going to put this out, pull it back and then...
What, a lead with no bait on?
Yeah.
What's that
I
for?
I thought I'd try that, I've caught too many this week. No, we're just going to mark it up and then wrap it up something.
So what are you casting?
I did cast last night, but I think I don't know. So it might have spooked and... Yeah, he keeps saying it does. I can't see it spooking that much.
Casting is so 80s, though, isn't it?
Well, yeah, but I'm the 80s, you know what I mean?
The bait boat. You've got a bait boat here, haven't you?
Kajagoogoo and all that, wasn't it?
Who?
Remember?
I do.
When you used to have your hair like that?
Yeah, and I remember yesterday, I didn't have my hair like that for the record. I started out. I did think of Andy Roth yesterday when I always think of him, Spandau Ballet True comes on.
Yeah.
Always reminds me of him dancing with birds up the palais, me and Pete in a corner, yeah, pretending we didn't want a bird.
Yeah.
I bought the tunes down with me when I do the Barbie.
Yeah.
He thinks I'm a chef. I've got him at it. Right. And I've told him that you don't. Yeah. I'll cut his hair and dress for him. See, we can get his hair cut.
Yeah.
Say, yeah, he'll do a good job. Yeah, I'll have a go.
Say he was an apprentice.
Yeah, you'll do. I'm not sure. You must have told him how many lies I tell. Yeah, because I don't think he believes anything I say.
No, probably not. So high, I guess. Strange magic, oh water.
Proper ones that really do work off solar. I think that's Carl's fridge. And then without shower, best shower I've ever had on a lake. Amazing. So there's your toilet facilities. You know, readily bring your birds and partners and boyfriends here, that's for sure. And as I say, very, very convenient. And the barbecue area through there.
Bacon, smoked bacon from Oaks.
John. From John,
Oaks.
Yeah. Yeah. Your soundtrack to the 80s. Bluetooth. Why don't you like this music?
I don't like it, mate.
Why?
I don't, it's too old. It just brings back bad memories. We want a bit of, like, since a bit of drum and bass or something like that. I mean,
it's banned on my phone.
Is it?
Yeah. And I'm doing the barbecue and I can only cook to music.
Yeah, fuck yeah. Barbecue.
Wait until we get Abba Gold. Abba Gold's on shortly, the full album. You'll love that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's it on a loop, innit? They start about four and it goes around to six and starts again, doesn't it? That's what it seems like.
So here we are Wednesday evening. Just had a shower, have something to eat and get the rods out. This is the most amazing thing, look. Kevin's barbecuing. Can you believe it?
That's from Holt, isn't it?
No, this ain't from Holt.
This is from Holt, isn't it?
That's Holt's chicken, yeah, of course it is. What?
Yeah, anyway, I said you'd do a barbie, didn't I?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right, because I ain't done much all week. I feel like I want to bring something to the party.
Yeah.
Yeah, apart from, you know, just single-handedly catching the fish.
Yeah.
I feel like I need to contribute with the food.
Yeah.
So
what we got here then, Kev?
Yeah, so what we've got here, you guys marinated. That's a homemade recipe of marination.
Okay, right, what's in here, Kev? That's Can you tell us or not?
No, I can't tell you. And then we've got Holt stuff here.
Yeah.
Sausages, not Holt's burgers. I didn't have time to get there.
Right.
But got Tesco's finest brioche buns, mixture of salad.
Who made that salad, Kev?
Me.
Did you?
Yeah.
You know, I never. Do you know what? You're a bit of a genius, isn't it?
No, I just.
Hey.
Yeah, and then we're going to skewer it all and put it on skewers.
Lovely.
All right.
Yeah, and what'd you do with them skewers? Because every time I do them, they get burnt.
Soak them in water.
Oh, do you?
Yeah.
Soak
them in water, and then they don't burn, and the meat and the vegetables come off it easier.
Do you know what, you come a long way from Romford, mate, and you?
I have.
Aye?
I have.
I can't believe it.
But, Dean, don't worry. By the time I edit this, right, it won't be me doing all this. Because I ain't giving away no secrets. People don't. Oh, it's only Eric that knows. I worked in a restaurant for 4 years.
Oh, of course you
did,
yeah.
When I was, like, 20 to 24.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, I do know how to do everything. I worked in a fishmonger's and a butcher's.
Yeah.
But just let people know.
And what about hairdressers? Because Carl, look.
Yeah?
I thought you was in a barber's when you was about 18, no?
I was, but you know what? You can't do nothing without it. Yeah, worry about that.
Lovely, it's looking good, Kev.
Yeah.
So what are we doing now then, Kev?
Just easy to cook when you skewer it. Then just got to make sure you're well marinated the meat.
Yeah.
No shop-bought marinades. I'm never that confident in them. You know, a homemade one, that takes me 20 minutes to do.
And you were not saying, are you? You won't say what's in that.
Yeah, it's a family recipe. It goes back 300 years.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, it goes back a long while.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll get you to do me some of that, mate, because that...
It's good stuff.
Yeah, it's nice. You been in the plunge pool or not?
No.
You ain't, though.
Too deep for me. I'm only 5'5".
I've said to you, there's some steps in there. You'd be able to probably dive in there, all right. That's looking good, mate, I've got to say. You have surprised me.
Look how I've seasoned this. You can't see that, but I've seasoned it.
Oh, is it?
So it's got salt, pepper and a marinade on it.
Gotcha.
Yeah, and you'll see what I do before we start doing it. You don't want dry things out.
No.
Yeah, with a barbie, it's got to be moist. And a lot of people, they just try and cook things and you start eating, it's all dry and hard and stuff. Keep it marinated, cooks much better. Well, cheers, boys.
Cheers, Kev.
Yeah, lovely.
I've got to say, you have let your guard down this week.
Why haven't I?
Yeah.
Quite special, isn't it?
Everyone thinks you can't do nothing.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, but I'm going to edit that out.
Yeah.
Well, no sooner had we had our barbie, Dinny's saying there's a storm coming. We're saying no, there ain't. He's telling us, yeah, it is. And sure enough, look at this. Din, You called it. This is bang on for down here, isn't it?
Yeah, I've just seen two or three run down here.
You have, yeah?
Yeah.
Look at that. That looks mad.
You're all tucked in up here.
I'm tucked in, yeah? I'm tucked in. I ain't going to hang about. I'll grab a bit of apple pie and have a cup of tea around there, yeah?
He's put it up there, the apple pie. He's took it up into his lodge. So he said if it come down, you could go up there and have
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I don't want to labour it, but it was good what I did, wasn't it?
Fantastic, Kevin.
Yeah, I know.
Do you know what? I've never in a million years thought you was capable of that.
Yeah, no, I know. I'm proud of myself. Yeah,
it's the same. I've seen one over here. That's twice I've seen both.
Yeah, what
seen
you can do? Twice. Look at them and then what casting walk,
yeah,
mate?
Just casting, like, catapult a few, and again, look.
Oh, yeah, got it, yeah.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Hey. Yeah, times now.
Yeah, fishing moving. I need to get back and get my rods out.
Yeah, you've got to get fishing.
Yeah, I'll just bait it up round now. So, yeah.
Looks all right, nice, then. It?
Yeah, good. All right, well, good luck then.
And you, Kim.
And yeah, get a big one. Get me and Colton keep an eye on my rods or something, yeah?
Yeah, for sure.
Right, I'll grab a bit of an apple pie.
Apple pie's in the lodge.
Yeah, well done, Din. Yeah, looks mad for it, doesn't it? Needed this. Yeah, they'll be chopping out there.
Yeah, they'll get in here.
Yeah. Yeah, it's been a slow week for Dinny so far. That weather, that should change. It should get some tonight for sure. Yeah, it looks mad for it.
I ain't being funny, Cole, but from your kitchen where these bins, you can see me. Is that the idea?
Yeah, just watch you all the time.
I never knew that. Oh, my God. I'll take a picture of it before I ruin it. That's a lovely looking pie.
Well, there's a contrast. 7:15 Wednesday evening, we had that barbecue just a couple of hours ago. The storm's come. I don't think it's going to last long, but it half cleared the air and the conditions are bang on, especially for Dinny down there. So yeah, hopefully he gets amongst them, but right now the rods are out, it's pissing down with rain and it looks mad for it. I don't think you can see it that well, but while it's raining, that porch extension on this ridge monkey, where the Oz tent ended there, that's about, I don't know, probably 20 inches long, makes all the difference. So you can sit under that readily, and it just gives you that much extra protection. Cup of tea and a bit of apple pie Wednesday evening. And feeling really confident.
Yeah.
There we go. 37 and a half. Wednesday evening. Well pleased with that. Mwah. Oh, lovely. Happy days. Thanks for that, Cole.
No problem.
Yeah, what a lovely afternoon that's been, hasn't it?
Yeah, it is. Big pucker afternoon.
What's
going on?
Oh.
Colder now.
Oh, yeah. That touch feel colder. So 40 and a half pound, second fish this evening, Wednesday night. Got it?
Yeah.
So you can get the camera a little bit lower, Cole. Yeah, you want it?
Yep. Yeah, mate. I'll
quickly get the other side. Thick set fish, isn't it?
It is.
How's that? Yeah, that'll do. Got it?
Yeah. There we go, she's gone.
He's gone. Yeah. Happy days. Second fish this evening, looked good for it, didn't it?
Yeah.
Didn't you got him jumping near him?
I haven't heard nothing, to be perfectly honest.
Right, yeah.
No,
best night we've had, hasn't it, since we've been here?
Carl's on his way round, it's a lovely mirror. Maybe scrape a 40. Yeah. So we've got one here, third fish, isn't it, this one, Cole?
Yeah.
35 and a half. What's it? It's gone midnight, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
There we go. 35 and a half pound, we're getting the other side. got a nice sort of short head and eye back, like the Croatian fish I was catching a few weeks back. Sort of humpy back. You on it?
Yep.
Lovely. Thank you, fish. I'm getting going back in the light, Cole. It's not above us. See? That's him.
Yeah.
On me, Cole. How good's that? Yeah. Thanks for getting up again, Cole.
Yeah, no problem. Yeah.
Cole's gone about half hour, and this has gone off. A battle-worn, very tiny-tailed, 37.5-pound common. There's me hand. Common there, early hours of Thursday morning, 34-pound. These fight really well. Well chuffed with that. Look at that. Beautiful mirror. Beautiful mirror, 37.5. About 4 o'clock Thursday morning. I think that's my sixth fish now. Superb. Got it?
Yep.
43.4. Early hours of Thursday morning. There we go.
Yep.
Lovely. See if we can get going back. Over the top. You want it?
Yeah.
Lovely, Carl, thanks. Well, that turned out to be a great night's fishing. I think I had 7 fish. Really enjoyable. Tiring, as we all know it is, but you know what? Wouldn't have it any other way. Right now, it's first light. Cole's come round. We're just having a cup of tea, and then we're going to put the drone up and get some, other footage. I got it during the day, and now we're going to try and sort of capture sort of sunrise, etc. But yeah, that wind and rain last night definitely helped. And I don't know if it was more body temperature and stuff, but yeah, getting in that water was a damn sight colder than the last few days. But yeah, now it's set to be warm for the next few days, so is what it is. And I'm going to suggest to Dinny, because I don't think Dinny's caught anything down there, to come up here and we'll have one rod each for the next couple of nights. And be company for me, a bit of social, and see if we can catch some fish for dinner as well. So anyway, right now, I can set the drone up, finish my tea, and get it up in here. Oh, it's Thursday morning. I had a hectic night. And this is my 8th fish since last night. And I'd only just put this out. I said to Carl, he come round, we put the drone up. You can see the bubbling going on out there. I think I've got his head up, Carl. Maybe not. You want it, Cole? So we've got to take us, it's just 56, 58, say 58 pound, less 4.5,
53 and a half.
53 and a half. Superb.
Ah, 53 and a half. Thursday morning, 8th fish.
Yep.
Let's get it outside. Is it saying record here?
Yeah, you're right.
Thank you, fish.
Oh, how good was that, Cole? Epic bite battle, wasn't it?
Pucker, yeah. Hell of a fight.
Yeah,
hell of
I'd only been out there 15 minutes after we'd done the drone.
Yep.
Put it out there, I said I could see the bubbling. They're certainly on Ken's bait, aren't they?
Without a doubt, yeah.
Certainly on it, yeah.
Well, you think they haven't fed all summer because of the heat of the water temperature has been up to 30 degrees in some cases.
Yeah.
These last little sprinkles of shower, bit of a northerly wind.
That helps.
Just turned it all on.
Massive. Just shows you about conditions. Don't matter what you book in advance and everything else, you're relying on conditions.
Without
and whilst it's been red hot this week, that little respite is just what I think the lake needed for this session.
Yeah.
So trying to sound like I know what I'm talking about now, don't I?
Well, what an amazing fish that was. Yeah, proper made up with that as well. So yeah, it's been a great night's fishing. Yeah, really good. So yeah, still bite time for a couple of hours. Then I'll wind in and go and catch up with the boys, have some breakfast, and regroup for this evening. But proper exciting fishing. Really, really enjoying this. Don't often get sessions like this. You know, this ain't hard water. It can be hard, so the boys tell me, and there will be hard times when I come here for sure, but right now I'm making hay while the sun shines, and it's one of those sessions that you don't get many of. So I'm proper made up.
Slow this fish.
Just sitting on the bottom, hugging the bottom.
Yeah. Tell you what, Carl, I'm inclined to wind that one in.
Well, we put back that 53 about an hour and a half ago. Put the rod back out there and it's gone again. About half past nine, Thursday morning. Oh, this is a fire, got to say. It's all better than your two 50 pounders. Nice one, nicely done, Cole.
That's on the jump.
Yeah.
32 and a half common. Real chuffed. There we go.
Yeah.
Got it?
Yeah.
Lovely. Oh, yeah, what a great morning or night's fishing that was. I've had enough now, I'm going back to a kip. Honestly, I need to go and have a rest. Cheers, Carl.
So, Dean, with this wind coming down here, you'd have thought you'd have been on them.
Yeah.
Did you hear anything in the night or anything?
Just a couple, yeah. Big one round to this left, but yeah.
It's mad, isn't it?
I've been sick, well, you've been waking me up all night. But,
yeah, well, we saw them, didn't we? Just as we left after dinner last night out there. Could it be that shiny line you've got on?
I think that's what it is.
Yeah, that shiny line.
You tell me that.
can't say the make of it.
No.
But it's shiny, isn't it?
It's shiny, isn't it?
Shiny, yeah.
Oh, yeah, but just...
You've got to stick that diver central on five or a spool.
Yeah, it's
been bulletproof.
I like it. I use that for sea fishing.
Yeah.
Brilliant stuff.
Yeah. This 6-pound breaking strain breaks at about 80 pound, doesn't it?
Strong stuff, isn't it? Yeah.
Anyway, this is Dinny's coming up with me, so we're going to have breakfast and stuff, and then, like I said earlier, we're both going to fish one rod the next couple of days till Saturday. But this is the scene at Dinny's, and you'd have thought it was mad for here, look. So guys, some of you, by the time you're watching this, will have seen my post on Facebook about a Mozzie watch, because Carl, who owns this lake, he just happened to mention earlier in the week how good these watches are. And this is it. Googled it off Amazon, 12 quid, got a couple coming, ordered them while I was here, and they basically, they're rechargeable, and they give off like a little high pitch buzz, and Carl swears by it, he says it's brilliant, so I'm going to get a couple and see how they are, but the fact that he rates them, and he's out here all the time, and they've had big mozzie problems here this summer, he reckons with this, you don't get bitten. So all those lotions I've had, all of us have had, and jungle this, deep that, stuff melts buttons, stuff melts gold, all of that. I think that might be a thing in the past in favour of one of these. We'll see. So brunched in.
Yeah, Oakes' sausages, them onions, cold gross, over in his little allotment over there. He's been down, he's got the best bit of bread in France.
That is lovely bread. That is lovely bread.
Bit of mustard.
And what have we got for dinner tonight?
So, pasta,
arrabbiata
sauce, bacon all cut up into squares, and like a spicy sausage. This, yeah.
Lovely.
Yeah.
So this is the scene about 11 o'clock Thursday. And then going back this afternoon with Din, I'm going to get in the shade, have a kip. Dean's going to get a couple of rods out, and we're going to chill. Well, I had brunch with the boys now. It's about midday Thursday. I've come back to the swim. I want to get my bed chair in the shade and have some kip, much needed kip. And then Dinny's coming round this afternoon, sorting himself out. He's going to have one rod. I'm going to have one rod on now. Hot area, and for the next couple of days, so it'd be a nice social for me and Din, and it just ain't been happening for him up the other end, so yeah, we'll have dinner, get back, get the rods out, and do the night. And I forgot, he snores. Fish with him at Rainbow, he really snores, so I'm going to be up one end of the, good job it's a double swim, he's going to be up the other end. Even then, it's that loud. Be careful what you wish for. Thought, it'd be nice to have a bit of company and stuff. Yeah, I forgot. He's a snorer. Up the other end, so Dinny's come up with me, and we're just sorting some bits out, and then we've come around to have a shower and some dinner. When you're up on the back of that wind, it's like you're in a different country. It is red hot up there, because there's no wind. You come down to this end, this is a northerly, and you just can't work out why Dinny ain't had some fish down here. It's mad for it. You know, really is. Look, if you was turning up here now, you'd be in this swim.
Well, what's the matter for Brett's?
You got a fan?
Yeah.
What for?
Well, because I left a little bit of smear on the glass. I've cleaned it now here.
Yeah.
Brett banned me from the Hebrew for that.
Kidding me.
So now I've learnt the lesson. Yeah, I've been banned 12 years now.
Have you?
Yeah, it's a 20-year ban.
Right, mate. Another 8 years, as it happens, if he sees this, you never know.
Yeah, no, exactly. Yeah.
You might rescind the red card.
Brett, when you're watching this, I'm a new man now. So I think my ban should be lifted, because I do know how to clean the shower.
Yeah.
I'm doing it here. Yeah. This is really what we need the girls here for, isn't it?
Well, I've always said that.
Yeah. This is what they're best at. Yeah.
I think a couple of them little Thai birds, Kev. Do you know what I mean?
Well, don't mention that. My owl will see that. Yeah, that'll bring back bad memories. Yeah. He's only joking now.
Yeah, you ain't got to have one with a cock, have you? Do you know?
Yeah. You need the biggest move.
That's a good thing. Look at the stripes on that lawn. He's just mowed it. Fantastic. Anyway, just had a nice dinner. Heading back now. Dinny's coming round. As I said earlier, fish one rod each. And, yeah, have a nice social next couple of nights. Yeah, as I'm walking back, this is the sort of stalking swim that you can fish during the day. So I'm fishing the opposite bank over there. The lodge and everything else is down there. Yeah, so you can sit in there with a rod, although that bank sticks in there with three buzzers on, the way to fish that is, just come around here with a rod and, yeah, for a few hours at a time. But yeah, sun's heading down and, yeah, exciting night ahead, I'm sure. Yes, it's about 7:30 now. Thursday, had dinner and come up, baited up. Dinny's up with me, so Dinny's got the left-hand rod because he's sleeping in my bivvy as far away as I can get him because he snores. And in fact, that ain't far enough. It ain't, I know it ain't, from Rainbow. And then I've got the right-hand rod because I'm here under the stars. So, yeah, exciting din, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is the scene. Yeah, this is the scene. Yeah, Thursday evening, got two nights left.
Come up here with Kev tonight. Just got our heads down, and he's in. Hooked it out over there by the island. Bit of side strain on, stop it going around the back. Feel alright, Kev?
Yeah.
Got him out of there?
Shoes on.
No sooner had I got that fish in the net, and it's in the sling now, 45 and a half, Din's rod's gone off. Just on cue. And my fish, it had gone from feeling like a grass carp to feeling like a small one to being 45 and a half. You alright there, Din?
Yeah, mate, good. Cold cope.
Oh, yeah.
Go on, you're all good.
So this was a real surprise fish, this. So we had two bites almost at once. We've got one in the net for Dinny. 30 common, and we've got this one. It's a beautiful fish.
Big frame fish, isn't it? Yeah. Good, you're fine.
Yep. How's that? Yeah. Difficult. Got it?
Yeah, mate, good. Yeah.
45 and a half. Was it, did you say 44 and a half, 45 and a half? I can't remember.
45, something like that, yeah.
Yeah, lovely.
Good nick.
Yeah, beauty.
Well,
all chuffed with that.
Well done, Ken.
Right, yeah, let's get your one out, Ken.
Right, mate.
So it's 37 and a half, yeah? Yeah, Ken. 37 and a half.
Yeah, got him?
Yeah. Happy days. Well done.
All right.
Yeah, superb. Yeah, you can go back towards me. Oh, yeah, that's it. Yeah, how good was that, Din? Yeah.
30, so what was yours? 40, 50?
45, was it?
Yeah, 45 and a...
37 and a half.
Yeah.
Yeah. Within 5 minutes of each other. Yeah, just about on cue and all bite time, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Said that, didn't I? Happy days.
The one you want.
Had to go. And it's gone. Well done, Din. Friday morning. What's it, about 8 o'clock, Cole?
Yeah. Get it back,
because
that's going right.
I know.
Get it back, Din.
You need to give that some stick. You don't want it going behind the island.
It's coming.
You ain't going to snap nothing. Just get that fish out of there, I'm telling you.
Well, it's over the other line at the moment.
Yeah, it's probably above the line, but you've got to get it from that island. Go on, pull it. That's it, pull. Big lump like you, pull it. Lovely, Din. Well, I've been saying, Cole, on the video that fisheries that can allow anglers to get into margins, I think this makes a lot of sense handling fish in water. Really does. Full credit to you. Yeah, that's it. You got it.
Yep,
got it. Yep. Nice one, Din. Well done.
Guys, I might look a bit of a plum, but I learned when I was at Sumba a few weeks back just how that sun can mess with your head. Not exactly sunstroke. Anyway, I've got this hat, widest brimmed hat I've ever seen off Amazon. But you know what? It done half do the job, not only of keeping the rain off, but keeping the sun off your head. Yeah, it's about 15 quid. Yeah, huge. And I've got a fat head, and it looks huge. Look at that. Hold the chin up. There we go.
Just before 11 o'clock, I said to Dean, we've got to give it to 11. And sure enough, his has gone off, and they've been fizzing over mine. And if I wind in and mine's tangled, then boy, am I going to have the ump. But anyway, go on, Dean, get that back. Well done. Got him out. Well done.
Years of experience, Kev, this is.
He is. You ain't lost it, Dean. It's like fishing for tope at Bradwell back in the day, wasn't it?
Remember that?
Long while ago.
You were sick all day, weren't you?
Oh, never again. Never again. There's a big head. Lift it up. Yes! Happy day. Well done, Din. 11 o'clock, we'd have been winding in now, wouldn't we? Just said 11 o'clock. Look at the back on that.
It's a biggie. Big old kit, really.
Yeah.
11 o'clock Friday. Dean's got a beautiful mirror in the net, a big one. Need to go and get Carl. Got a bike here. Well, they'll never go on a bike again. Oh, not least of all, the seat. The seat's up for a 6 footer, not a 5 foot 5er. The sun. And I said I didn't like the way he got things done. Sleeping on the job. Raindrops are falling on my head, they keep falling. But there's one thing I know, the blues they send to meet me won't defeat me. It won't be long till happiness steps up. Raindrops keep falling on my head, but that doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me, 'cause I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining, because I'm free.
nothing's worrying me. It won't be long till happiness steps up to greet me. Raindrops keep falling on my head, but that doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me,
cause
I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining.
So it's 48, 49, 50, 50. £1 less 4.5 pound. Yeah, oh, I thought it was bigger than that, didn't it? Don't matter. It's a beautiful fish, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah, but that bit of stomach, that'd have been a monster.
Yeah. And that's the case with a lot of them at the moment, Carl, isn't it?
Yeah, they're empty, mate. They've just not been.
That,
yeah, they're not feeding, haven't been feeding all summer because of the heat.
Yeah, superb, Din.
Yeah.
Yeah, lovely.
All right.
Yeah, bang on. Well done. Get swimming away.
Cool,
needed that one, didn't we? Bang on time, Din, wasn't it? Hey?
Well,
I just wound in my rod, having put it out again last night after that fish. And I couldn't make out why I hadn't got a bite. Wound it in, I had a stick on the bloody hook. So they must have picked that up. So bloody painful. But anyway, but Dinny had three fish, and we're going to celebrate now. He's doing a fry up. So it's about 11:30 now, Friday. Gonna go around, chill out. It is red hot again today, red hot, not a breath of wind. And then head back and fish the evening. I'm gonna slowly pack up off in the morning. So pack away the bulk items and got the last night to make it happen. There's a guy now, have a cup of tea, have a throw up. Din, wound in that rod, had a stick on it.
No.
Bloody great twig. Oh. Something had to be wrong, didn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, with that fizzing going on. Bloody gutted.
Could have had 60
kills. Oh, anyway, that's fishing, isn't it? Yeah, so this is the scene, midday, Friday. Just the weather for a fry up. Well, we got a stew this evening.
Yeah.
Done a bit of Pim's, not too much of it.
Yeah,
I couldn't. Yeah, in this weather and that, and also got my fishing head on.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wouldn't bloody get up. I wouldn't be fishing drunk.
And you, have you told everybody you had a stick on the end of your rig?
Yeah.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, bloody just did.
Surprised me, that did.
Yeah, bloody gutted. There had to be a reason with all that fizzing going
can't
on.
Can't make them mistakes in places.
Can't make them mistakes.
Can't.
How do you overcome that though? Swim out there and put a little camera on the end?
What you do, you put your rig where the geezer tells you to put it.
Yeah. There's old Carl working away, look. So he does the main lawns by hand and the big lawns with a tractor.
Fried
potatoes and all. Fried we've got to celebrate, don't we?
Yeah.
Oh, happy day. Done us proud there, Din.
Good
evening. Yeah, so Friday evening. I'm doing the burgers for the boys. Chopped peppers, special burgers with my marinade, olives on the side, and let's start the barbie. This is the scene, been red hot, flat calm all day today, but it's that night time. Dinny's decided to come back down here. So, he came into my swim, he had three, I had one. 80s all over again, I know I keep bringing it up. I obviously need therapy. Tell me, boys, how good is it?
Oh, I don't know, Kev, I think mine's better. John's burger.
Look at that. Oh. Well, it's 7:15 Friday night. Had a lovely dinner with the boys. Now back round at the swim. Gonna get them out. I had a zig rig out for a few hours this afternoon. There was some fish cruising up and down, and didn't manage to trap one, but as I say, right now, get them out, a cup of tea, a bit of apple pie, and then Dinny decided to go back down there, so fish moving down there. Let's hope we can get them there. Now I've got the two rods. Let's see. But feeling confident, obviously. And we had four fish between us last night, so that weren't bad going at all. Let's get them out. Well, rods are out now, approaching 7:30, and I've put a rod probably a third of the way out, where Dinny and I saw some bubbling along that line, this morning, some heavy bubbling and a couple of fish. So I haven't fished short yet. So one's there, and then the other two rods in the normal spots. Dinny's just got his rods out with Cole. And sun's setting over there. And this is the scene our last night, Friday. It's been a cracking week, not over yet. All to play for. Well, boys, cup of tea. 70s tunes on the radio. What's left of an apple pie, didn't eat most of it. And here's to hopefully another good night's fishing. We'll see. Friday early evening, 38.5. Great start to the evening.
Dancing with it,
yeah. Here we are, just before midnight, Friday. Fish 39.5, second fish of this evening. So far. Real beauty. Get the other side of him, yeah?
Yeah.
Got some little starburst scales on him, hasn't he?
Yeah.
She.
Yep.
Lovely. Should we get going back, Cole?
Yep.
You want it?
Yeah.
Lovely. Superb, Cole. Thanks for that.
No problem.
Yeah, lovely. She's going to back this one. Another 39.5. Very early hours of Saturday morning, about 12:30, 1 o'clock I think it is.
Yeah, half past one.
Is it 1:30, yeah?
Yeah, 1:30.
Got it?
Yep.
Lovely, just get it back. Thank you, fish. Right, nice fish, yeah?
Yeah. Birdie.
There we go. Happy days.
Well, 8 o'clock Saturday morning, I was dead to the world. And had a bite, got a lovely common in the net. Carl's on his way round, but I went and got my van last night, because it's up at the car park, because the rain was forecast, and sure enough it was, and has, and it's just again what we needed. So got a couple of hours to go before we're packing up. Gonna get it back out there because this not only is this bite time, but just what we need, just what the lake needs.
Well, this ain't hanging about. Common here, my full fish of the night, 37.10 ish. This fish, and we'll get a quick doodah of it, and it's going. I know it. Got it.
Yep.
Thank you, fish. Oh, that was nice, Cole.
tell you what, your anglers turning up today, it's been nice having a bit of respite from that heat, wasn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, good for them. Yeah, happy days. Cup of tea. Well, this is probably my last fish, not putting the rod back out now, but this is the one I had the fish on earlier. Stuck it out with just a little bit of bait. And yeah, it went off within half hour, 37.5 pound, nice pretty mirror. The 29th fish, couldn't be more happy. There we go. Well guys, one rod out, everything packed away. And this is the scene. About 9:30 Saturday morning as I'm packed up. And what a cracking week fishing I've had on an amazing lake. Very fortunate to get amongst them. They were certainly up. Oh, look at that. Did you see that? Look at that fish come out. I hope that captured that as I was panning round. Yeah, so this is the scene. Dinny's packing up too. And then we've got like a 5-hour drive back from here to Calais. But yeah, it's been, you know, I'll save a synopsis for when I'm home, but it's been an amazing week, really. 29 fish, I'm proper made up with that. 250 pounders, those fish, you know, they'll be feeding before long, really heavy. And yeah, guys coming here, they'll be feeding up for the winter. There'll be some more good catches, that's for sure. But for now, just going to leave that out for 10 minutes, sit down, chill, and then get around, have a shower, and then get the train home. Thank you, Swim. Well, Din, I'm off.
Right.
Yeah, what a cracking week that turned out to be.
Caught
a few in the end, you as well, didn't you?
Yeah.
So, yeah, worked out a treat. Yeah,
can't wait. You laid back?
I don't know yet, I need to check. Yeah, no, I've been presumptuous by leaving my pims there, expecting to come back and drink it.
You won't drink all that, mate.
And, so I'm going to head off and I'll catch up with you when I'm back, yeah? Just wait for Cole to get back.
Yeah,
and,
on a winter trip, don't we?
Yeah, yeah.
On the method.
Conditions dependent. Yeah, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Well, guys, it's Sunday. Beautiful day. Got back yesterday from Renard, and what a cracking week that was. And yeah, thanks to Carl and Dinny, Carl being the lake owner who prefers not to be on camera. I was hoping to catch up with him for an interview because what he's done at that lake is astonishing. And anyone who's been there will know that he used to own up to a good few years back now what's become known as Pascal's on the John Court complex. He sold it to Pascal, put his money into that, and yeah, the enormity of the work he's done there is incredible. So yeah, I look forward to going back there. Thanks again, Carl, and not least of all Dinny. It was great, you know, great week's fishing, very sociable. It was hot, but we caught some cracking fish, and yeah, as I say, I can't wait to go back. And as I'm speaking, I've still yet to final edit my previous three trips. My first trip was at Bowes with John. Oh, what was that now? May, I think. I can't remember. May, June. I then went to Rainbow with Kevin 11. I then went to Sumba with Stuart. And then to Renard. Right now, with COVID and all of that stuff, whatever, you know, whatever you believe, whatever, you know, your thoughts are on that. The fact is that, you know, the country's in a bit of turmoil, so I'm not quite sure what the movements are over the coming few weeks and couple of months come to that. Got some fishing planned, but at the moment, yeah, can't really confirm anything. So I'll be playing that all by ear. If I get a chance, I'll be going over my syndicate for a night or two while the conditions, or when the conditions break. It's been red hot here as it was last week in France. So yeah, for people watching this, you know, there's all manner of challenges, and I guess fishing isn't the priority, although at times we try and make it that. You know, workloads and other commitments and everything else that's going on needs to take the priority. But for now, that's a wrap on the video, and I'm hoping this coming week now excuse me, to get some editing done and yeah, finally get them on YouTube. We're way behind, but that's, you know, case of work taking the priority, and my colleague not always having the time to edit when I'd like her to. But anyway, so yeah, thanks for watching that, guys, and by the time you'll have watched this, you'll have seen the other videos, and then by the time you've watched them, I'm hoping that I'm fishing back abroad, but time will tell.
Just get in it.
I ain't getting back in it. I'll do myself injury.
Yeah, you'll be all right.
Just... fuck that. Oh, you knew that was going to happen. I did.
It can't be that fucking odd again. just for the record, boys, Kev tried the hammock. And you know how difficult they are.
There's an act to that.
I should have filmed him.
You've got to sit dead centre.
Crikey.
Try again, Kev. Come on.
No, I'm getting
on, no,
in
you'll
there.
Be all right. No, go on, look. Show him how to do it, Carl. Get dead centre, Kev.
If you sit dead centre, you're okay.
What?
Look, you can sit there like that.
Yeah, but what if you want to lay in it?
And then you just flip round like that.
Oh, right.
Let him try again. Come on.
It's because you sat too far back.
It's like riding a bike, Kev.
Well, I'm determined not to do it again.
Yeah.
You can, that,
doesn't it? Oh, you can let go. You can let go of the sides.
I'm getting in it again. No. I'm not in a picture.
Oh, don't.
Fucking hell.
Yeah. So, not only can't Kev ride a bike, he can't lay in an hammock either.